right now with the prosecutors, prosecution in this case, who the case did not go their way. This is Stan Levco.
Was there any sense based on the questions that they asked that it might be going this way?
No. I mean, I thought they asked questions for both sides, so I wasn't anticipating this.
Are you planning to appeal this decision?
Oh, no. First of all, I couldn't, and if I could, I wouldn't.
Looking at all the evidence in this case, what do you think it was that the jury ultimately just did not appear to agree with on your side?
Well, obviously, you'd have to ask them, but I would imagine Bonet's credibility would probably be a big factor.
And where do things kind of go now on your side? Obviously, the case has been lost. What do you kind of think will happen next for David Camm?
Well, he's free. You need to ask him.
You said if you could, you wouldn't. Why wouldn't you?
Well, the jury, you know, we put on as good a case as we could. And the juries spoke pretty clearly. And you know, there's no such theoretical thing as appealing a not guilty verdict anyway, but I wouldn't. I wouldn't see any point.
The two big differences in this trial versus the others were Bonet and touch DNA. Do you think they hurt you, one over the other, or one more than the other?
Well, it wasn't. There was also evidence that didn't come in this trial. So the two big differences that arguably were pro-defense, and then there was some evidence that state didn't get in. So, you know, again, you'd have to ask the jurors. I imagine different jurors would have different reactions to different evidence.
The sexual assault evidence with regard to Jill was stripped out. Mm-hmm. And going all the way back to the original trial, the mistresses were stripped out. Mm-hmm. How much of that do you think would be a factor here?
Well, I don't know. I mean, obviously, he was convicted the first and second time when that was in and didn't get convicted this time. But each trial is different. Each juror is different. It's hard to tell.
Did you even expect a verdict to come today? And yeah. What did you think when it was only 10 hours of deliberation?
Actually, the 10 hours didn't bother me at all. And I did think it would come either, I would have guessed today or tomorrow. And with hindsight, it sounds doesn't sound very wise, but I thought it was going to be a guilty verdict.
Hindsight 2020, is there anything different you would have done in this case?
No, I mean, obviously, no, not in terms of trying it. I thought our evidence went well.
You talked about the evidence you weren't allowed to present, the evidence of molestation and the evidence of all the affairs. Was that a fair judgment on the part of the courts barring you from using that? Do you think that was fair?
Actually, I do.
So you thought it was fair of them to prohibit you from
yeah.
introducing that evidence?
The one thing that bothered me is there was some evidence of some statements he made that they prohibited that I thought should have been allowed to be in. But, you know, I doubt if, you know, one statement like that would have changed this result. So. I mean, it's a pretty clear result. If it were a hung jury or something, I think you could second guess certain things or say, you know, this piece of evidence might have made a difference. But this is a pretty clear verdict.
Is this verdict also a verdict on bloodstain pattern analysis and on touch DNA?
Well, you'd again have to ask the jurors that. I thought our bloodstain evidence was pretty credible, but, you know, who knows?
And that is the attorney for the prosecution that you heard from right there, Stan Levco, talking about his surprise that the case ultimately did not go his way and the way for the prosecution in this case, as the defense ultimately made their case, won their case, that there would not be a guilty verdict in this case. And, you know, as he kind of said, he says he would not do anything different throughout the entire case that was tried here today, or this a few weeks, I should say, here at the Boone County Courthouse.